The symptoms of pertussis typically start off with a child with a nonspecific runny nose that may go on for a couple of days to 2 weeks, usually not accompanied by fever. At that point, after a few days to a couple of weeks, the child will start having a cough. And the cough is a prolonged expiratory burst of coughs without inspiration, and it can go on for many, many seconds. The child will turn initially red and then blue. At the end of the coughing episode, the infant or child may have a deep inspiration, which gives the name whooping cough to the disease, because what you'll hear is as the child takes a deep inspiration against now a narrowed airway.
In 2012, we're seeing a real rise in the cases of pertussis, and so this is a really critical time. So far in 2012, in New York State alone, there have been 970 cases of pertussis reported, and this is in contrast to all of 2011 when there were 931 cases in New York State. So we're really seeing pertussis on the rise, and we want to encourage everybody to get a Tdap booster, especially pregnant women who want to do everything they can to protect their baby.
Whooping cough is very contagious and can be easily transmitted from parent to child, child to child, or child to parent. The most serious complications of pertussis occur in our youngest patients, those infants less than 6 months of age. And infants less than 6 months of age usually acquire pertussis, whooping cough, from household contacts, most often, in fact, their mother.
Pregnant women want to do everything they can to protect their newborn baby, and occasionally they may feel like vaccination is not a safe option. But in fact, the opposite is the case. A newborn is very susceptible, and the most important thing a pregnant woman can do is get vaccinated so that she doesn't inadvertently catch pertussis elsewhere and bring it home to her newborn who's most at risk. What we like to see families do is create a cocoon around their newborn, which means that every adult who comes in contact with that newborn has been vaccinated with their Tdap booster. That means grandma, grandpa, aunts and uncles, babysitters, caregivers, anyone who's going to come and see that precious newborn should have their Tdap booster so that they're part of the cocoon that cradles that newborn and keeps it safe.